So we could learn later today what restrictions will be eased for residents of New South Wales who are fully vaccinated. We heard yesterday from the Premier Gladys Berejiklian, who said she'd announce more details later this week, potentially a restriction to be eased for fully vaccinated people in New South Wales. That's what we're hearing. We're expecting a press conference from the Premier, as always, at 11 o'clock Eastern Standard Time this morning, and we'll bring that to you live here on ABC News Radio. But this, of course, comes as the state reported its highest COVID caseload yet, 919 infections yesterday. Some of the worst hit areas continue to be in Western and Southwestern Sydney. Joining me now is the Federal Member for Parliament for Barton, Linda Burney, which is based in the inner southern suburbs of Sydney, also the Shadow Minister for Indigenous Australians. Firstly, can I just ask you about your electorate? I mean, it includes areas, just for our national audience who might not know, like Canterbury, Campsie, you know, some of these hotspot suburbs we've been hearing about in South and Southwest Sydney. How's it going there? What are people telling you?
People are angry. They feel like the city has been divided. You are very right in what you say. So the electorate of Barton sits squarely in Canterbury, Bankstown, Georges River and Bayside councils. Three of the 12 councils that are hotspots determined by the state government. People out there are doing their best. But like you, and like everyone, it's been 9 weeks of lockdown with enormous focus on the areas around Barton.
What do you think is behind this, Linda Burney? I know there's been a lot of talk about whether the city locked down too late, but, you know, it's been weeks and weeks and weeks now. The COVID infection numbers continue to skyrocket. Why do you think the virus has been so hard to stamp out in the community there?
There has been a slow coming to understand the dynamics of the community in southwestern and western Sydney. And Ed Husic, the member for Chifley, who's in the Mount Druitt area, has been calling on more support for the ADF to set up vaccine clinics. So in essence, it's been about the availability of vaccine, but also the constantly changing messages. And it took some time for the government to realise that they are best to work with community leaders and trusted people in the community. And, of course, the area that we're talking about, Thomas, is in many ways low socioeconomic. They are really big families and it is highly multicultural. That is a very different mix to many other parts of Sydney, and that took some time for the government to appreciate.
I just want to ask, because there's been a lot of concern about the spread of COVID in Australia's Indigenous communities, and look, that's happening now. I'm thinking of remote towns like Wilcannia. As the Shadow Minister for Indigenous Australians, I mean, do you think enough's been done to protect people in these communities?
No, I don't think enough has been done. Well, what we do know, Thomas, is many of these communities are very highly populated by First Nations people, but there are non-Aboriginal people in those communities as well. So we need to think of them as whole communities.
Of course.
75% of the 400 or so cases in Western New South Wales are Aboriginal people. And alarmingly, 40% of those infected are children under the age of 15. We know that Dubbo is one of the epicentres, but the spread now is right across the region. There is an urgent need for more focus to be put on these towns. I mean, think about this, Thomas. If this virus travels down the Darling, as it has, down to places like Moama and Detton in the south, into South Australia, up through the APY lands, into Central Australia and over into Western Australia. That is an unmitigated disaster. There has to be a national plan for what about communities that have high Aboriginal populations that are absolutely vulnerable because of the health outcomes and because of overcrowding in houses. It is a dire situation, and I'm not being dramatic.
Linda Burney, based on what you're hearing, is the vaccine getting into some of these Indigenous communities, particularly the ones that are really affected at the moment?
No, it's really, really patchy. The ADF is out there, as we all know, at the moment, which is important. But the real issue that these, Thomas, is the capacity in those communities. I listened to a young woman interviewed on your sister program from Wilcannia yesterday who talked about the fact that there are very few people left to do food and baby bottle and, you know, nappy deliveries because you're either a close contact or you're infected. I mean, think about a town like Wilcannia, where one in every four people have the virus. That's what we're talking about. And the other thing, of course, is that many of these towns, A, don't have supermarkets like Gadooga, don't have doctors, don't have medical services, so they have to travel to other towns, and we don't want people travelling from town to town. So those things need to be appreciated. Plus the cultural considerations, which are easy to articulate and important, and of course the fact that they are the houses or the pet, that there is 16 people in a 3 or 4 bedroom home, and it is impossible to isolate.
We're almost out of time, but I just want to ask, because there's a lot of talk about, you know, a potential easing of something that we're hearing about from the New South Wales Premier. I don't have any information on that. I'm not sure if you do. We're expecting an update.
No, I'm sorry, I don't either.
Yeah, but what's your view on that? I mean, you're hearing about these communities that are really feeling the impact now. Your electorate in southern Sydney is feeling it. What's your view on anything actually being eased at the moment? Should that be happening?
Well, it's almost... And I mean, I'm an avid news listener, as you know. It's almost like the Premier and the Emergency Cabinet is in a parallel universe. We've got the world burning on one hand, and yet they're talking about easing restrictions, which I guess is a reward for people that have been double vaccinated. There aren't a lot of people that have been double vaccinated. So what's decided is who knows what, and who knows what the restriction is. But it seems to me that if the New South Wales government is going to move ahead with lifting of a restriction, they also have to have chew gum and walk at the same time, and have to have a focus on what's going on in these communities out in Western New South Wales, plus what this means, what message it sends to people in the 12 LGAs that are under harsh restrictions.
That's Linda Burney, Shadow Minister for Indigenous Australians and Federal Member of Parliament for Barton in the inner southern suburbs of Sydney.